Hello, my friends. I hope you're doing well. I hope you're doing good. I hope you're ready for another YouTube video from your old buddy, DadCraft73. We're back here in the sky playing some 1.10 modded Minecraft. Man, you know we're playing SkyFactory, and we love it so much. Oh, my goodness. We have so much work to do today. I can't even begin to tell you, but now, just because we have work to do today doesn't mean we haven't been doing work already, man. We've been taking care of business already. I want to just grab a couple. I don't need that. I'm trying to empty some stuff out of my inventory if I could. I need some cobble. Let's see. So we have maybe a couple trodden bricks. That might work. Yeah. We have 285 million cobblestone. We're doing pretty good. Grinding away at that, man, I don't know if we're gonna make it. I don't know. It's gonna be tough. If I could at least get a billion before we're done with this series, I would be happy. I'd be happy, happy. Alright, I need some chests as well. Let's get a couple diamond chests. Maybe like, I don't know. Let's just get all of them. I'm not sure exactly how many we need. And then I want to get one of these, I guess. A bow. Let's see. How about leather? How we doing with leather stuff? Maybe I'll get a pair of pants. That and that. Okay. Just for now. Do I need anything else? Yeah, let's get some stars. Let's get some nether stars. Let's get, I don't know, like 3 stacks of those. Let's see. Actually, 39. Maybe 4 stacks. That might be good. And then some dragon's breath. Let's get 2 stacks of that. Okay. Yeah. I mean, we might need some other stuff. I have a feeling we probably will. We're going to be back. Oh, you know what I'm going to do? Let me find something here. Let me make something really quick. Where is my... You know what I can't find? Is it in here? No. Oh, yeah, it is in here. Okay. I need a wireless thinger. I need one of these guys right here. Can I make one of these? Do we have the stuff? Yeah, okay. Let's make one. And let's head back over here to our... Where are we going? Oh, man, I'm growing tons of chorus plants here. Man, I'm telling you what, the halitosis generators are probably the hardest ones to make out of all the ones that we've had to make, all the different generators, because they require purple blocks and they require end rods. So you need popped chorus fruit, and then you need some, I guess, well, you need it for end rods and you need it for the generators. And it takes like 3 stacks or so. So I've got 9 plants. Oh man, I guess I'm missing one. Let's go up here and steal one of these guys real quick. Put that guy down right there. So I have 9 of them growing around here. I mean, they're doing okay. I get like a stack or so every time, so it's not too bad. All right, let's head over here to this crazy place. So between the episodes, I have all the generators installed. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. All 16 times 39 of these extra utilities generators are all in. Whatever. It's the most ridiculous thing you've ever seen in your life. Okay, so this right here is disenchantment. So what we're going to do is I'm going to put this guy right here. I'm going to put this guy like so, right? And then, oh, do I have an exporter still? Oh, no, what? Ha ha ha. It doesn't matter if I have an exporter because I'll be able to get one. I have cable. I guess I don't have my exporter. But, you know, we're going to just stick this here, right? And then we can get this guy out of here like so, and we can say, exporter, I would like to have... Oh, I do have them. Dang it. Well, we got this wireless grid there because you never know. Oh, man, get out of here. Eggs and manure. Dang chickens. They're always messing around. Okay, so I'm going to put an exporter on this guy. I guess I got to break this cable. Let me just do that quick, and we'll stick this exporter right here. Now all of these conduits are turned off. So we're going to do compare MBT, no, and I'm going to put this stuff in there and this. Now, theoretically, this thing should start filling up. So yeah, we can dump these guys in there and all this stuff. Let me see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, I mean, that might be enough. Why am I not getting bows? See, bows, man. Bows don't like to come out for some reason. I don't know why. Compare damage, no. Now will the bows come in? Yeah, okay. Yeah. So we're going to get this chest filled up. You know, this one is going to be rough, right? Because not only do we have to run it, but we have to get it filled up with RF. And it seems like these guys run for a while. It doesn't really tell you how long they run, but it doesn't really tell you how much RF they generate either. This is the only one that's not like that. So anyway, the plan is when we decide to turn these on, we're going to have to activate this, right? And have it do its deal. And I'll bring the, you know, the pieces like the gold and stuff like that over here as well. Put as many different kinds of enchanted items that we possibly can in here. And hope for the best that we can keep it running. What is this guy? Oh, potion generator. Oh, I meant to bring a potion with me. Dang it. Okay. I got to do some work with these guys because we got to get the empty bottles out. So we're going to have importers on all of these dudes. Oh, man. I hate it. And then, what is this? Overclocked? Yeah, overclocked. I've got it filling up with coal. So this is the one we're actually going to do a little bit of work on right here. So let's see. I want to go like this. Nope, I don't think I want it there. Do I want it there? No, I need it down one. Okay, so the first thing I need to do is, if you look here at these generators, right, you can make it so, well, I think, I gotta go check to make sure. I need to run redstone conduit down this row. I need, because I need a piece of redstone conduit and I need a piece of item conduit. And then we've got to set up a timer to pulse items into these generators essentially once a second. Or once, not once a second. So it's every 5 ticks, we're gonna let this thing go and pulse an item in here. Because if you remember from whenever we built these rainbow generators over there, the key to these guys is they don't have to be running the whole time. They just have to run, I guess, twice a second. They have to be in like a running state. So that's essentially why we have these relays back here, where the relays essentially control the timing, if that makes sense. So the relays let it set up where, oh, what am I trying to say? The relays make it so, this right here, by the way, oh no, dang it. The relays limit the amount of power these things will export. So essentially it slows them way, way down. That's what I'm trying to say there. Okay, let's go here. And redstone is going to be disabled for that guy. Yep. And then I want to put a piece here. Can I not put a piece there? There we go. That'll work. Okay, and then I'm going to go down below here. And temporarily, we're going to put this block in, and then this block, and then I think that's all I need. And then I'm going to set a timer here, right? And I'm going to say, oh, hello, be quiet, phone. Oh, my goodness. Thank you, Java Dad, for liking my tweet of the fact that I liked your video. I appreciate it, but I'm trying to record videos here, crazy guy. Dang it. I always forget to turn that thing off. Okay, let me go over here and check something. Let's go to the power sphere. And we'll see how we have the overclock set up. So, what's the deal here? I don't think we can control this guy. Nope. Let me see. What do we got going on here? Oh. Yeah, okay. Yeah. All we're doing here is using this thing to control how fast we can get items out of this thing. Oh, that's not going to work very good at all. Oh, I don't know. We might just have to blast it. I don't know if we can get away with doing that. So this setup right here, if you don't know, and I don't want to take too much time talking about this stuff because we got tons more work to do. That's for sure. Where am I getting these extra? Oh, cool. Anyway, so what this thing's doing is every 5 ticks, it runs. So essentially 4 times a second, it pulses, right? You can see it going blink, 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 blink. And every time it blinks, it allows an item to come out of this drawer, right? And go into this overclocked generator. So you can see that it just is pulsing. Because this thing burns items so fast that you can't keep it full. It's impossible to keep it full. So I'm not sure exactly how we're gonna set this up, unless I have. Do you think I need to have an individual thing? Blah blah blah. Oh dang it! So we got to figure out how to make this work. And I'm not sure. This is probably gonna be the hardest one for us to automate to keep running. I mean, I could just stack one of these drawers clear full of items, and then just spray them in there. But man, it'll burn through a stack of items in like no time. Like if I go here and I take a stack out of here, did I get a stack? No, maybe I gotta go around the front. Let's go around here real quick. And if I like take a stack out and I put a whole stack in here, I mean, see how fast it burns through them? I mean, it's insane how fast it burns. So the only thing you can do is limit. You don't have to limit how fast this thing runs necessarily. You have to limit how fast you put things into it. And I've got 39 of them that I have to find a way to limit. And that is going to be rough, rough. Bark, bark. I'm not sure exactly how we're going to make that work. Dang it, how much is wither? Okay, go away. Hi, thank you. So, I'm not sure exactly how we're going to do these. If you guys have any ideas, I'm going to think about it in the rest of this episode and see if we can't come up with a plan. I mean, we might have to actually feed coal into these guys individually. So we have to have like 39 storage drawers maybe feeding these guys. Man, these things suck. I hate them. This is the worst one. Oh, the rest of them, man, I can handle this guy. Oh. I don't love the disenchantment generator either, mainly because I just don't have an easy way to get enchanted items. But this guy right here is the hardest one to automate. This is the big stick, right? But anyway, we'll figure it out. If it means I have to have 39 drawers all filled with mini coal and have exporters running down the backside of them, ripping coal into them as fast as it gets taken out, man, that's what we'll do. That's what we'll do. Dang it. Okay. But anyway, that's this setup. So over here, if we go back to the generator list here, everybody is configured the way it needs to. All it needs to happen is I need to just turn on these item conduits, and theoretically, well, we're not quite ready because we've got potion generators we got to square away. Those are those. We get a little bit of lag over here. Understandably so. I mean, check out all those generators. That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever seen in anywhere at any time. Man, we're so crazy. So I'm not sure exactly how we'll do this. I have to go through and take these guys out, though. I don't need these. I want to just take the redstone out. Can I do that? No. Okay, well, we'll just take it all out. There's probably a way. Oh, like that one didn't come out. Yeah, I gotta break it like that. Okay. So we gotta take all this redstone conduit out, and then we gotta figure out a solution. I'm not sure what to do. I'm thinking we're probably gonna have to have drawers for each one of these guys feeding items in. can you even imagine? Okay. Well, I mean, if that's what we need to do, I mean, I'll do something special for this generator because it's more important for us to get a billion RF a tick than messing around with this other stuff. Man, whatever. It is what it is. I'm also a little worried about the pink generators because those guys, man, those are no joke either. Here, let's put that back. Because the pinks, man, they rip through dirt like nobody's business. And it doesn't really matter what you try to put in there. It burns it so fast. So it's not like you get any economies of scale out of doing... Oh, hi. I want to break you. You get any economies of scale for doing anything else. It's just the way it is. So, oh, dang it. I'm getting a little bit of lag here, man. Oh, I didn't like me messing around with all these generators. There and there and there and there. Okay. Yeah. And actually, this has got to come off here, too. Hi. I'm stuck. Okay. you come loose and then go back. Okay. So, I mean, this will control essentially input out of this guy. So if I put this right, I mean, it might work, right? I mean, I guess we could test it. No, what? That's not what I want. I hate this thing. Can you tell I'm a little salty? Man, I've been grinding. Why won't you go up there? I want it to attach there. Is it too high? I don't know. We'll figure it out. I might have to raise this up a step. Anyway, so we got to figure this out. And what we'll do here in this episode, let's actually run a test and we'll see. We'll put a bunch of upgrades in here. We'll get this thing filled up with coal. And we'll see if we can get items in all of these things by pulsing them out of here. I don't think I can. I mean, maybe I just need to not even have this timer and just flat out rip them out of there. And then maybe put a couple exporters on this thing, all with max upgrades, just trying to keep it full. I mean, I guess that's an option, right? I mean, if I have, like, you know what I could do? Here, let's, where's my thing? I could do this. Okay, so let's go crafting, let's do upgrade. One, okay, let's get these. And then we're gonna apply 1, 2, 3, 4. Can I do another one? Okay. So this thing's going to hold 20,000 or 2,000 stacks of this coal, and it's going to craft it and fill it up. I need to put a speed upgrade in there, stuff like that. Let's just get rid of all this stuff. We don't need this. So we're gonna brute force it. Instead of trying to limit it or do anything like that, we're just going to flat out brute force these items into this thing with max number of speed upgrades in the conduit, right? That's what we're going to try to do. And if it doesn't run them all, if it's not fast enough to run them all, I mean, it's going to rip that coal right out of there too. Woo, daddy. But if it's not fast enough to run them all, we'll just come down, you know, like 3 or 4 times throughout the string of generators and stick in another chest of coal, you know, or another drawer full of coal and handle it that way. Okay, so that's how we're going to do this. Halitosis, we're just literally going to have another chest up here like this, and we're just going to put some stuff in there, right? Because halitosis runs for a while, so it's 10 minutes, and we're going to slow it way down, so that's not going to be a problem. This guy right here is exporting gunpowder. You know, we might need to put an upgrade on him, probably just one. And then this guy right here, we're going to have another chest over here, and we're going to load this chest with some nether stars, okay? Because they kind of rip through there kind of fast, 2 minutes for a nether star. So, but we're going to extend that too. So we'll be able to, I think it'll be okay. This guy I'm worried about, and potion I'm worried about, pink I'm worried about. I mean, we have, here, we got to do upgrades. I think we're going to need, like, I don't know. Let's just stack this guy clear full too. We'll have to see, because this guy is essentially going to be the same thing. I don't really have any dirt here. Let me get a stack of dirt really quick, and I'll just show you how fast it rips through a stack of dirt. Dirt. Okay, there we go. Let me get some, like so. And if I stick this dirt in here like this, I mean, it's not super fast. It's half a second, and we're going to slow it down, I think. I mean, maybe that's as fast as it'll go. So it's going to use a piece of dirt every half a second, so we might be okay. We might be. We'll see. Well, I'm a little worried about that one. Man, culinary, I'm not even sweating it. We're using rice. And man, if I like take a stack of rice out of here, like so, like that, throw it in there. I mean, it burns it quick, but it's not super fast. Yeah, that should be fine. Yeah. So, I mean, I think we'll be able to get it done. Ice, I'm not worried about because we're loading this thing up with snow. Slime, I'm not worried about. We probably need to throw an upgrade on here. I want to try to front load as much of this stuff as I possibly can. You know, anywhere that we have a drawer, this guy, he needs more. Yeah, this guy's got it on there. This guy is what? What is this guy? Potion. Yeah, we're going to make tons and tons of... We actually probably need to stack this guy all the way up. Mini coal for this guy. Yep, we already talked about him. This guy, yeah. So that's probably good. So I need to figure out a way to do some mass bottling. So if we come back over here to the the workshop really quick. I know we just spent a long time chatting about that. And, I mean, it's a lot of work that I've been doing. Oh, hello, lag. Man, we're getting a little out of control here. So, if we remember from our last episode, here's our little potion setup here, where since we've got a mechanical user with 20 upgrades in, it's one of the into one of the Pam's harvest wells, and then we are exporting full bottles, and then or importing full bottles and then exporting empties, and then we're essentially filling up that deal over there. So, and I know we have, let's see, water bottles. So we have 544. So if I make a ton of bottles, like if I go and we make a ton of these bottles, not bottle of air. I just need glass bottle. Yep. Oh, I don't have any glass. Let me make some glass. Can I make glass? Yeah. How about we make like, I don't know, a bunch. Like that much. There we go. Okay, so that's going to go over here and run through. No worries. So if I make a ton of bottles, I can probably pre-fill, right? Which I think is what I'm going to have to do and hope for the best. Now, when I tore down all that cobblestone stuff over there, check out this, man. I have 270 speed upgrades. So we're going to put 15 upgrades in all those conduits, man. We're just going to hope for the best. We're going to spray it and pray. Was that what the deal? Spray and pray? Just brute force as much as we can, because we'd like to be able to sustain some of that volume if we could. We don't want it to just click on and then click back off. So let me do a little bit of work. I would like to maybe, I need to harvest a bunch of purple blocks. I need to do some other stuff. And I'd like to at least get the rainbow generators made today and turn everything on except for the disenchantment generator. Because that one, we're not going to have very many options. Because if we look here, bows are gone. Well, bows are almost gone. How about leather? Leather is gone. The only reason leather's not gone is I didn't bring a hat over here with me. Gold. Yeah, I mean, we don't have tons. We have a good bit, though. We can get one of those, one of those, one of those. I don't know if all this stuff's going to fit. But I don't think we're going to... So if I can get everything running and sustained in today's episode, then tomorrow, we should just be able to turn this thing on and let it fly. Right? Right? Oh, man. So I need to harvest a bunch of purple blocks and things like that. Let me get some of that stuff done, and I'll be back with you whenever it's time to make some rainbow generators. And I guess I'll see you in a second. Alrighty, my friends. We're back. Oh, I think we're ready to give this thing a test. So let me show you what I've got going on. Let me fly over here. Man, I really need to get my draconic armor back out. It's so much faster. So we got one rainbow going. Actually, I guess there's two rainbows going at the. How is there two going? That's kind of strange. But I will take it all day long. I'm not sure how I have two enchantment generators running. Yeah, getting 51 million RF a tick from those two guys. So what I did is, I'm a little worried about. So I have 11 rainbows sitting over here. Man, the big issue is each one of these. Oh, hey, that one's not configured. Hi, let's do this and get you on the network. Thank you. Okay, so we have 11 rainbows over here. They're all configured. They've got six things. So whatever, 11 times 20, 250 million, 275 million. If we can get them all running, I'm a little worried about my enchanted stuff. I might have to just stand here and grind out a ton of books. I don't really know else how to do it. I guess I could fire up the soul well, and maybe get some enchanted items from that. Now that I've exported all the unenchanted stuff, this guy over there is working like a dream. So here's what I've done. I've copied the settings right here from this guy. So if we take a look at this guy, this is just putting coal. I mean, it's not a big deal. I'm not too worried about it. We have tons of coal. So always active, and then this, right? So I've copied round robin, always active. I've copied those settings, and theoretically, I should just be able to come down along here like so and copy those. And then those should all light up. And those should all light up. And those, we're going to get some lag. Yeah, for sure. Let's see. Is that guy working? Oh, got to set this to extract. Oh, yeah. Getting a little bit of lag. Oh, daddy. Okay. Let's go turn these on. The good thing about these, like, slimy generators and frosties and undeath and stuff like that, culinaries, I'm not too super worried about how much. Oh, man. I don't know. We'll see. What is this? This is disenchantment. Oh, man. We're going to be ripping through items. Let's see if this works. I'm a little worried about this guy. Not sure we can get them all turned on. We'll see. Oh, the lag is real. Turn this one on, turn this one on, turn this one on, and turn this one on. So they should all be running. Like, all 39 of them should be running. Let's go over here and see if we have full rainbow activity. Well, there's a bunch of them going. What's not running? Halitosis is not running. They should be running here shortly, though. Overclocked is not running. Yeah, it's going to be so hard to get all those going. Dang it, I was worried about that. Yeah, I'm not sure. Let's see. What was not running? Nether Star should be running. Oh my goodness, that's super loud. Ah, I'll fix that. Don't worry. So halitosis should be running across the board. Should be round robin. Why is that not doing round robin? I don't want that to happen. That's not good. That should all be round robin. Yeah. Round robin enabled. Always active. Strike. I'm not sure why that's like that. Oh! No! Dang it! Okay. They seem to be working now. I guess we have to have them stacked in there in a certain way. Oh! Alright, let's see now. I know all those TNTs are running. Man, we have lots of rainbows active. What's going on with this guy? Nether Star did the exact same thing, didn't it? Okay. Oh, we're going to go over here and get ourselves withered to fix this. And then overclocked. Man, overclocked. That's going to be a... I knew that was going to be a problem. Where are my overclocks? Oh, potions are running? Overclocked. Ripping that stuff out of there. Where's it even going? Yep, so overclocked is a problem. Nether Stars is not a huge problem. We just have to go in here and grab these out like this. There's like four stacks of them or something. There we go. And then we just need to take these guys and spread them out like this. Right? And then it works, I think. Okay, so overclocked is going to be the problem. Ah, there's the wither. I knew I was going to get that. 17 seconds. Yeah, I have to deal with that. We'll have to get some mufflers over there to deal with the TNTs. Not a huge problem. Now we should have lots of rainbows going. Oh, man, they're not. Why are they not? Overclocks. Yeah, man, I guarantee overclocked across the board. Yep, so I figured that'd be the problem. Okay, so now, I figured we'd just do a little bit of a test. I mean, that's just the way it works. Hi, can I be unwithered? That would be wonderful if I could be unwithered. Okay. So what I want to do here is I want to go back in here and I want to disable this. And then, we want to copy. And we want to... copy that, right? So let's turn all these off now. So we should be able to turn all these off. Let's just verify. Yeah, close enough. Turn off. Turn off. Turn off. This guy needs to get turned off. Active with signal. How much is in there? Oh yeah, we're still doing good. Lava's not a problem for sure. You know, that was a good test. I knew the overclocks were going to be a problem, and we're going to have to solve that for next episode. We're going to do a bunch of things. Man, dirt is gone from these guys already. This, disenchantments. Let's see how many stuff we used. We didn't do too bad. We're still doing all right. This guy. Make sure this guy is off. And we're going to get withered again, but whatever. It is what it is. And we're going to burn through some materials here, which we thought we would. Okay. So they should all be now turned off, I hope. So yeah, we had, I don't know, four or five of these guys running, but over, so we found out a couple things. We had to learn some lessons, right? First lesson we learned was that we have to separate our materials in those chests to get them to work the way that we expect them to. This guy's still running because he's in there. So I know we jacked in a bunch of power into this thing. Hi, stop being withered, please. Yeah, we did almost a trillion RF, like, pretty quick. This guy is still running along. I need to go shut him down, too. So what we're going to do is we're just going to turn off the disenchantment generator. Because these are the ones that I have the least amount of supplies for. The rest of these can run. I'm not too worried about it. We have to do... I'm also going to turn off the pink dirt. Man, that's a huge issue. I think everything else can just run. I mean, they don't use that much power. Not a big deal. Okay, so we learned a valuable lesson today that the overclock generator is like I figured, is going to be the big stick. So in tomorrow's episode, we're certainly going to have to get that figured out. But we're close. So I'm going to do a couple things between the episodes. First of all, I'm going to get myself the other 40 generators running. I mean, everything else was running, right? I mean, we were in pretty good shape. I think we were working the way we need to. We need to build up some supplies, and I'm going to go AFK and get tons of coal and get all those things filled. I mean, we're not going to have a tremendous amount of time to get a billion RF, but I think we can get all 40 of them running if we can deal with that overclock generator issue. And I think what I'm going to have to do is get a chest or a drawer, a storage drawer, for each one. I mean, that's the only thing I can think of. So I'm going to have to make a bunch of those. I mean, I don't have very many storage drawers. Yeah, I don't have any. but we could... Oh, no, drawers is what I want. Drawers. Yeah, so we have 12 basic drawers. We can make a ton more. I mean, I'm not too worried about making them. And we can make as many as we want to. We have tons of chests. So I'll make 40 of those, get those all set up, and we'll get exporters on them and export a bunch of mini coal into them. You know, we might be able to do timers on all of them and pulse them like we do. You know, we're figuring it out. You know, I knew that this was just going to be a test run. Man, we had like five or six of them running, though. I mean, we were ripping in a couple million RF a tick. I promise you we were. At least 1.150 million. I bet we had six of them running at one time. That was actually a good first test. We need to store up a couple things. I'm going to go turn on my Well of Souls before I log off tonight. We're going to work on a couple other things. And then I'm going to go let that Well of Souls run. And I'm going to go AFK. And we're going to try to get all 40 of them running in tomorrow's episode. We may or may not do it. It's going to be close. Overclocked is going to be the issue. I can promise you that's going to be the problem. That is for sure. But we had them running. Oh, daddy. We're close. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it so much. Until next time, please remember to be cool. Don't be a fool. And from the Sky Factory, where... we are on the edge, the razor's edge of a billion RF a tick. I guess we'll see you next time. Bye, everybody.